The Gokhar faction, led by Abarizal Bakri, is reporting to police Agus Gumiwang Kartasasmita, who's been appointed by a rival group to head the party's faction in the House of Representatives.
The report was filed by Ali Shamierta, the lawyer acting for Ade Komarudin and Bambang Susatyo, the chairman and secretary of the Gokhar faction in the House of Representatives. Both are from Abarizal's camp. The lawyer says Agus has been reported for allegedly falsifying documents and for unpleasant actions because he forced his way into the Gokhar office at the legislature and used words that were deemed unpleasant by Abarizal's camp. The lawyer argued Agus had no right to enter the office because he'd already been discharged from the party by Abarizal.
Tentang pemalsuan data, di mana Pak Agus Gumiwang memakai kop surat dari fraksi Partai Golkar, di mana Pak Agus Gumiwang itu adalah orang yang bukan lagi sebagai anggota Partai Golkar, karena sudah ada surat pemecatannya pada bulan Juni 2014. Dan juga tentang pasal 335, di mana Pak Agus Gumiwang pada saat itu memaksa untuk masuk ke ruang fraksi dan mengeluarkan kata-kata yang tidak menyenangkan. Dan 167 adalah memasuki daerah yang dilarang, yaitu untuk memaksa untuk memasuki ke ruangan fraksi.
The Secretary General from Abarizal's camp, Idrus Marham, had earlier criticized Agus and a number of his colleagues who attempted to forcefully occupy the office last week. Idrus says Ade Komarudin is still the lawful head of the party faction in the House because a decision hasn't been made to replace him.
Nah, ini juga terus terang saja kepada sahabat saya, Dr. Agus Gumiwang, yang selama ini kami tahu di Golkar itu kami sudah pecat dulu dan kemudian tidak pernah masuk. Mestinya apa ini, kehormatan DPR, MKD mestinya sudah mengambil tindakan. Kenapa tidak pernah masuk? Tiba-tiba datang ingin merebut pimpinan fraksi. Ini kan hebat.
Idrus says his faction is often subject to threats and intimidation from its rival, but he says it's not afraid of defending the party's executive board. He says a decision by the Justice and Human Rights Minister to recognize Agung Laksono's faction as Golkar's lawful leaders was a form of pressure against his own side.
Selaku pimpinan Partai Golkar ingin mengingatkan kepada mereka bahwa cara-cara berpolitik ancam-mengancam, tekan-menekan itu tidak hanya bertentangan dengan nilai-nilai yang menjadi dasar perjuangan Partai Golkar, tetapi bahkan justru sebaliknya itu akan merusak citra Partai Golkar di tengah-tengah rakyat dan secara tidak langsung akan mendegradasi ketokohan orang-orang yang ada di sana juga sebagai kader-kader Golkar.
Idrus says an attempt to take over the party's faction office at the House of Representatives would only sully the public image of Golkar.